What is going on, guys? Briar Rabbit here. Today is Tuesday. That means it's time for the weekly Nightfall Strike solo. This week it's on Cerberus Vey. We're going to be fighting Valus Tark. And we got some interesting modifiers here. So let's go over them real quick before we launch. Epic, heavily shielded, and highly aggressive enemies appear in great numbers. Nightfall, obviously, if all players die, your fire team is returned to orbit. Light Switch, minions of darkness deal much more melee damage. That one really isn't going to come into play too much. Angry, minions of darkness won't flinch even after massive damage. This is a pain because we'll be fighting a bunch of phalanx. So that's an unfortunate one. And Juggler, no ammo drops for your equipped weapon. But there's no elemental damage type this week on the Nightfall. So your weapon choice is going to be much more open than normal. But it's a little disappointing not to see a elemental damage. So I'm going to launch this out and I'll show you guys what weapons I chose once we land. All right, guys, we have landed on Mars. I'm going to quickly go over the weapons I've chosen. Now, we're going to mainly be running into enemies with solar shields and some scions with some void shields. So the things I'm going to bring along are Vision of Confluence and Atheon's Epilogue just to burn down shields. I've also got a Fatebringer and a Devil You Don't, and a Suros Regime. I'll probably be kind of switching up between most of those, but my main gun here is going to be Vision of Confluence, just trying to burn down solar shields. Next, I've got Icebreaker for the same reason, and I did also bring Praetus Revenge for void shields on the Scions, so that should help quite a bit. And for rockets, you know, I just brought Hunger of Crota. I do also have Yallahorn, which I might use against the final boss just to try and burn him down faster, because without any kind of like elemental damage, it's going to take a long time to burn him down. So let's jump into it. The first thing we need to do is head on down and start the mission. And this Nightfall, the darkness zones don't actually start till well into this strike. So you can be pretty careless for, you know, first like third of this strike. We're going to pop that, leave our Dinklage behind, back onto our Sparrow, and this is the first part we're going to kind of just bypass on our Sparrow. We're going to fly up here as fast as possible. Darkness has not started yet, so even if you die here, it's not a big deal. Just stay on our Sparrow all the way through this area here.
Be on the lookout for his lieutenants. They're just as dangerous.
All right, and this is your first big encounter here. Lucky for us, darkness is not turned on yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to Sparrow my way through as much of this as I can. Jump off. Wow. And not worry about the fact that I just died. I don't even know what killed me, to be honest with you. Because darkness is not turned on. So I'm just going to, you know, do it again. And I'm just going to try and get through this. Without having to do this whole fight, because this fight takes a long time, and it's easier just to get through it, just like this. So what you're going to want to do is stand right behind these tubes here, wait for that door to open, and just head out that door. Alright, sorry about my voice today, guys. Been sick for the last 3 or 4 days, and finally feeling well enough to get back behind the microphone, but my voice is still a little screwy. So this is our next big encounter. This one's much more dangerous. Obviously, darkness has been turned on. So we're going to mainly use sniper rifles for this. So bring a ton of special weapon synthesis. And if you have an icebreaker, it's going to be very helpful. We'll just start by taking this guy down. I wonder if Xur will ever sell the Icebreaker again. There's so many people who don't have it. See, those Scions have massive, massive shields. They're really hard to take down if you don't have a Void Sniper. You use a Void Fusion Rifle too if you want to get a little closer to them, but they're actually somewhat dangerous because Light Switch is turned on. And they have that kind of, I don't know what it's called. It's like that kind of area of effect damage that they do where they kind of shoot that blue stuff at you. grenade back there. See if that gets him out of there. Gotta actually hit him. Alright, and we're gonna pop. You know what? We're gonna go back to Icebreaker, I think. Because our next set of enemies should be popping up. I'd like to get rid of that Scion with Praetus Revenge. Let's do that. So I'm going to be doing a lot of this for the next, I don't know, 20 minutes. Getting through this fight is all about just sniping for me. There's a bunch of Scions up here. We've pretty much done with them. But down there, we're going to get a bunch more Scions. And obviously you can see all these guys. I'm going to snipe every one of these guys. I'll be using Icebreaker. And whatever weapon I feel I want to use at the time. Sometimes I'll switch to Aphrodite Spear if I'm using a... if it's a non-shielded enemy. But for the most part, I'm just going to use Icebreaker because it's easy. And there's a ton of damage here. Like, these guys are going to do a ton of damage. Not having a elemental damage type this week, I mean, it makes it somewhat safer for us, but it just means that it takes forever to burn down these enemies. So you're going to see me fast forward a lot while I'm just standing up here sniping, because it's not going to be particularly interesting to watch. And my voice is a little ragged because I've been sick. Okay, so now we're going to start actually doing damage to lieutenants. We got to be careful here. We don't want to kill the last lieutenant until every ad has been cleared out. So other than that, we're pretty safe here. You can get criticals on those guys if they're just standing there staring at you by just aiming really close to their shield. And my guess is that there's still ads over here that I can't see. And they're probably Scions. Which are annoying. Yeah. And we want to be careful because once the ship comes, that ship is very, very dangerous to us. So I'm going to head back here, switch over to my Praetus Revenge. And my Atheon's Epilogue and start taking out the Scions. I see one there, and I think I saw one up there. Alright, that ship comes, get back to cover. That thing can mess you up in a hurry. Luckily, the gun is pointed actually at the area where you should be fighting from. But we're not fighting from there. Just kind of trying to be selective with my ammo. I'm not seeing those Scions, so... the Scions are shifty. They're crafty little bunch. So So I'm going to switch over to Efreet Spear. Take some pot shots at these guys. Alright, I'm gonna have to push it in, I guess, a little bit here. Switch over to Icebreaker, regenerate some of that ammo. You see, I've got one of the... Whoa! I did not see that guy was right up there, so I gotta take out that guy. The Colossus here. Don't want to get killed from that guy. So I see one of the lieutenants up here, but I really want to take out these ads. Here we go. That's not gonna work. Let's move back to Vision of Confluence. Oh, nice long range rifle here. Take these guys out from afar. Alright, that's our third lieutenant. We're not really worried about lieutenants right now, though. We're worried about scions and ads. Alright, I'm going to switch back over to Praetus Revenge and try and take out some of these scions. My suspicion is there's another one right in that area somewhere. There he is. Oh, there's a third one. Is that one going to show its face again? Ah, that was two misses. Come on out. Scions know when you are trying to snipe them. They're very good at kind of hiding. But they're very dangerous in this week's Nightfall at close range. Come on. I do not see that last scion. And I want to take him out. There he was. Oh. There we go. Was there another one? Yeah, there's a couple more. Ah. Alright, lucky for me, there's not a whole lot of places for him to hide up there. And the reason I want to get all these guys done with before I take on the lieutenants is because once I take out those lieutenants, the tank spawns, and all my attention is going to be on that tank. I do not want to have it 50-50 on a tank and a scion. I got to switch back to void damage to take that guy out. He's just not going down. So maybe what I'll do is actually take out one of the lieutenants and take out that last scion. Alright, so... I thought I had an angle on him there. Oh, is he going to make it easy on me and go up there? That's great. That's good news. All right. That way I can use this angle to take care of that scion. Ah, scion. Come on. There we go, finally. Alright, now I'm just going to use Icebreaker to clean up these last two guys, and we'll move on to the tank section. In fact... that ain't doing much, so I'm going to stop. You can critical hit these guys. Their head kind of pops out from behind that shield every once in a while. And you can get a critical if you just kind of wait for it. Alright, there we go.
I'm picking up another one of his lieutenants heading this way.
So our last guy here is in a tank. We're going to wait for him to land, and we're going to use this area here as a safe zone. As long as he kind of comes over and hangs out over there, we're going to be pretty safe. He is going the other way, though. Alright, so what I'm going to do is actually switch over to Black Hammer. Because this guy's critical zone is so big. Wow, that was close. Try and take three pot shots at him and then watch for a... The nice thing about this spot is that he often hits those trees, but not always, so be careful. Black Hammer does pretty good damage to this guy. And never has to be reloaded. As long as you keep hitting those criticals. Making it a very good weapon for him. That one's coming through. That one is too. Don't mess around with those, by the way. You don't want to lose this tank. You know what I mean? Wow. Alright, he's dead. I'm gonna switch it back
to
Icebreaker. And we're gonna head into our final fight. After we run into that thing. You can bypass all these enemies here. Now the next area, a lot of people bypass this area, which I do too when I'm doing a regular strike a lot. For the Nightfall, I find it to be just dangerous enough that I'd rather actually just sit at the top of the hill, snipe all the enemies out of my way, and then move on unimpeded. excuse me. A lot of times you'll find that you run into this area and the area's already cleared out because the team has cleared it out for you. And that's what we've run into today. If that wasn't the case, I would have just cleared it up. Cleared the whole area up from right there. And I don't find that it takes too long. It's pretty easy to do. And I don't think it's even a darkness zone, so I'm not positive about that, though. You might want to be careful, just because. Alright. So we've got a bunch of Scions here, some Phalanx. Not a particularly dangerous area, but you know, you always want to be somewhat careful whenever you're doing a Nightfall. Take it slow. I like to use this top area. I find it a little bit easier from up here than trying to do it from down there. And you see how good those shields are on those Scions. So I think what I'm going to do is just switch over to Atheon's Epilogue and see if I can't burn those shields down a little faster on those guys. Yeah, that's much easier. No, there's another. Yeah, he's right over there. This guy here is a giant pain. Because traditionally, whenever I have him about to die, he'll hide undercover. Regen his shields up, but this time he's not being too much of a pain. Alright, there's some guys underneath me. we'll just finish this room up and then move on to our boss fight. Alright, now we're going to begin our boss fight. I think there will be a couple of guys in here we got to take care of really quick. Oh, where'd the other one go? There he is. Now, last time we did this on a Nightfall, I went into that back corner. You can also jump up on those lamps. I'm going to use this piece of cover and that piece of cover. And we'll see how this goes. You want to stay pretty close to these covers to avoid getting blast damage. And we are going to burn this guy down. Of course, we're going to be using Icebreaker because ammo. Trying to get headshots when I can. His head is very small. I'm sure his mother's still proud, though. Alright. And I do not believe the ads are gonna bother us back here. But I've been wrong before. I'm gonna go pick up that heavy. Those guys are shooting rockets too, huh? That guy's shooting rockets too. I did not anticipate these guys having rockets. Thank you. I'm gonna switch over to Vision. I don't know about this new spot, fellas. I'm getting a little too much traffic from those guys. And once the Scions come out, that's gonna get dangerous in a hurry. You know what, I'm gonna put that guy back on for the Scions, which I know are coming. He's gotta be moving soon, too. On his way over. Man, that guy's got a lot of bullets in that gun. See how quickly I go down to that. That's crazy. I don't think I threw that far enough. Ah, here we go. Oh, I like this. This is nice. Oh, you didn't like that, big boy? That's nice, you don't take any splash damage from here. Boy, I'll tell ya, I almost wonder if they just forgot to put void damage on the list of modifiers, because Atheon's Epilogue is just burning these guys so fast. Faster than I think it should be, without any damage modifier on it. I wonder what Praetus Revenge would do. Two in 1566, I think Icebreaker was doing 3,000, right? I gotta hit him in the head, find out. 2,500, I don't know. Right. Get that little headshot in there. That's nice. Oh, how's that feel? That feels good, don't it? Right up in the face. Oh boy. I don't know. Atheon's epilogue seems super effective. I don't know. It's doing about the damage I would expect it to do there. See if I can pop these guys real quick. What's up, buddy? Yeah, maybe those guys are just more squishy than I think they should be. Whoa. Alright, we almost got this guy. A few more shots to the dome ought to pretty much take it down for us. Ah, come on. All right, I'm thinking one more dome shot. Nope, maybe one more after that. God, he's got no health, there we go. All right, so I do like this spot. It's a little more dangerous, I think. But I like it compared to that one in the corner over there.
But in the darkness rising, more fleets will come and new leaders will rise. We must be ready to face them all.
Alright, we want some Hawkmoon here. Give us that sweet Hawkmoon. That sweet, sweet Hawkmoon. That's all we want. Is Hawkmoon. Give it to me. Give it to me. Working on my Icebreaker, too. Did a lot of damage with Icebreaker this time. I think I probably did more damage with my Sniper. What is that? Plug one. I've already got one of those. Damn it. I just got one of those for, I don't even know what. I think I was in the Crucible and one dropped for me. Ah, man. Oh, well. Still another day without a Hawk Boon. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button if you like this video. Hit subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.